Good morning, I'm Larry Wooden, the Green Winer. I'm standing in front of the wines here at Bunker Hill Vineyard Winery in DeWitt, Florida. I'd like to talk to you today about something that's near and dear to our heart, and I'm sure it is yours too. Very seldom does a week pass that either FedEx or UPS will bring us boxes, unsolicited boxes, of empty wine bottles from all over America. Because you see, Bunker Hill Vineyard and Winery is the greenest winery in America. I know you've heard me say that before, but we're also 100% recycled on wine bottles. So what happens is people find us, recognize that no wineries in their vicinity take their own empties back. So they find us and say, and at their expense, they put them in boxes, pack them up, and send them to us, so we can repurpose them back into wine bottles. Now that's a significant deal, because I want you know this, but substantial change in our country has never come from the top down. It's always come from the bottom up. It's always come from we the people. We know this. It's always been this way. Everybody up top's happy. This change has to come through us the people. But what's happening here at Bunker Hill is totally grassroots. Every wine bottle we've ever used in the 11 years right now, and this, the years are growing, that we've ever used to bottle our wine in has been in a recycled, repurposed wine bottle. And every bottle we've ever used has come from our customers just like you. They're all repurposed, every single one. So when that delivery shows with the empty wine bottles, what happens to them? They get cleaned and sanitized. The old label's taken off, our label's put on in there, and they go right back into circulation. When you bring your bottles back, exactly the same thing happens. They get clean, sanitized, and put back into circulation. Because we have to remember that a wine bottle is made from glass. It's 100% recycled, and there's no end time to it. You can go home, enjoy your wine, rinse this bottle out, bring it back to us, and we could do this for a million years. And this bottle would continually go back into circulation. Glass just has no end time. It's a perfect material and can be cleaned and sanitized forever and ever and ever. The problem we've run into in America is that we're it. We're the only winery that is 100% recycled. Now, every winery should be. If you visit a winery, or maybe you've seen some kind of promotion going on, if they're green and they're doing something fantastic, just keep in mind, a winery cannot be green unless they're 100% recycled on their own wine bottles, and we're the only one in America. This is 60% of a winery's carbon footprint. So if they're not taking their own empties back, there's nothing they can do to catch up. This is the bull in the china shop. This is the big deal. We're throwing in America's landfills today. Just get this. This is crazy. About 4 billion, now that's not an M, that's a B, perfectly reusable wine bottles into America's landfills every year after recycling. Now, in addition to that, if you throw in these sparkling wine bottles, look at the top, it's different, that's for your wires. This is twice the thickness, so you can add another million years into this one, because when it goes to a landfill, that's 2 million years. Now, let's put this in perspective. If we were in Europe today, and not in America, you would expect every winery in Europe, and they do, by the way, to take their own empties back. They clean and sanitize them and put them back into circulation. I believe the latest numbers are about 9 times. Forgive me if I missed that by a percentage point or more. But it's about 9 times. They clean and sanitize them and put them back into circulation. In America, there's only one winery, and that's us at Bunker Hill Vineyard Winery. No other winery in America thinks it's important enough to take their own empties back. And they're not mandated to do so. So the factory wineries in America, they absolutely refuse to do it. So we have to start pushing back. Remember, this is grassroots. This is us, the people, making a total difference. We can no longer accept that a wine bottle like this goes to a landfill. Wherever you purchase your wines from, one of the questions you need to start asking is, how do you get those empties back? If they say we don't want them back, then my suggestion to you would be very simple, and I hate to be this harsh, is when you change your policy, then I'll come back and enjoy your wines. But we have to start pushing back as Americans. This is our country too, and we cannot afford to create a huge environmental disaster, and that's exactly what we're doing, by not requiring these wine factories to take their own impies back. Remember, you have the facts on your side. Every winery in Europe and Bunker Hill in America are 100% recycled. This is no small deal. Now, we do many other things at Bunker Hill besides wine bottles, recycle, and repurpose. But I did want to specifically highlight this. You know how much energy it takes to replace this wine bottle. It's phenomenal. And what has to replace is fossil fuel. So if you have any concern about the environment, you've got to start looking at these wine bottles. We can no longer afford to just toss them aside. They have to be repurposed by the winery. So when you visit wineries, ask them how they get them back and expect them to start taking their own empties back. It's that simple. We do at Bunker Hill, so, and we welcome you. So keep us in mind. We take all of ours back. It's no question here. And we do the same with, of course, our jams and jelly jars too. So people come and enjoy these. We take the jelly jars back also. So until next time, this is the Green Winer. You can contact us at www.bunkerhillvineyard.com. Again, that's www.bunkerhillvineyard.com. So if you have any comments or any questions, you can certainly get a hold of me through there. So until next time, salute and happy days. I'm the Green Winer.